If you're concerned about privacy with online AI tools, this video is for you. OpenWebUI lets you run large language models, also known as LLMs, directly on your machine, keeping your data secure. OpenWebUI, formerly called Ollama WebUI, is a user-friendly web interface designed to work entirely offline. It's completely free and supports various LLM runners, including Ollama and OpenAI models. Before we jump into setting up OpenWebUI, here are the prerequisites. Ollama lets you run LLMs locally. To install Ollama, follow the installation guide on the Ollama website. There's even a video I made specifically for setting up Ollama on Mac. Check it out if needed. The second prerequisite is Docker. This tool is all about containerization. Get Docker set up using the official documentation. Let's head over to the OpenWebUI site and copy the command to set up the tool using Docker. Open the terminal and paste the command. Run this command. This installs OpenWebUI. To check if it's running, use the command docker ps. As you can see, the container is up and running. Once everything's set up, head over to localhost at port 3000 in your web browser to access OpenWebUI. It's time to sign up and set up your first user account. The account will automatically have administrator privileges. This means you'll have full control over the platform. You can create additional user accounts later if needed. Once you've created your account, you're ready to chat with AI directly through OpenWebUI. The interface is clean and user-friendly, making it easy to start interacting with your chosen language model. First, you need to select the LLM you want to chat with from the Select a Model drop-down menu. Remember, these are the models we previously downloaded using the Ollama CLI tool. To see them listed here, Ollama needs to be running in the background. Let's quickly switch to our terminal window and run Ollama using the command Ollama run followed by the model name. Once Ollama is running, simply refresh the OpenWebUI page. Now you should see the available models you downloaded. We'll cover adding and removing models directly through the web interface later in the video. Let's select Ollama 3 for our first chat. Next, type your question or prompt in the text area. Hit enter, and the system will send your prompt to the chosen model, and the AI's response will appear right here in the interface. That's it. You have your own AI tool like ChatGPT set up on your own machine. You can refine your prompts, adjust settings, and have fun generating new responses. You can download or remove language models directly from the web interface for easy management of your available models. To download a model, refer to the model name listed on the Ollama model page. Let's try Gemma model by Google. Click on the settings icon and navigate to the models section. Type the name of the LLM you want to add in the Pull a model from Ollama.com and click download. Wait for the download to finish. You'll see a progress bar that gives you an idea of how long it might take based on your internet speed. Once downloaded, the new LLM will be available in the selection menu. Choose it and start chatting. These models can be storage hungry. To keep things tidy, remove models you no longer use. It's easy. Just pick the model name from the Delete a Model dropdown and click the trash can icon. Want to chat with your AI about your private data or documents? That's what retrieval augmented generation is. RAG lets you bring in information from your own world. Documents, articles, anything you have access to, without ever uploading it on the cloud. This way, the AI can understand your specific requirements and give you more relevant answers, all while keeping your data secure on your own machine. There are two methods to integrate local documents into your chat. The first method is the direct upload. While chatting, click the plus button and choose the documents you want to use. You can now chat with AI about your uploaded document and receive responses based on its content. You can also upload local documents from the dedicated documents section in OpenWebUI. Click the plus icon and select the files you want to add as sources. Now simply start your prompt with a hashtag symbol in the input field. A list of available documents will appear. Select the one you want the LLM to consider during response generation. A document icon will appear at the top of your prompt, confirming successful retrieval. You can now chat with the attached document, and the AI will provide responses based on its content. We just covered how to access local documents, but you can also leverage information from the web. Begin your prompt with hashtag followed by the complete URL of the web page you want to reference. OpenWebUI will retrieve and parse the content of the specified URL. Now you can start chatting with the web link as usual. You can also generate images using OpenWebUI. This image generation can be done through two backends, Automatic 1111 and OpenAI DALL-E. To use Automatic 1111, install it and launch it with this command. In the OpenWebUI, go to Settings, Images, and enter the address where Automatic 1111's API is accessible in the API URL field. Turn on the Image Generation flag and choose the model. Once you are satisfied, click the Save button and close the window. Use a text generation model to write a prompt for image generation. We asked the model to create a prompt to generate a futuristic cyber truck. After the response is complete, click the picture icon to generate an image. Here you have it. We have just generated an image using Automatic 1111. OpenWebUI also lets you generate images using OpenAI's DALL-E models. To get started, head over to the Settings menu and open the Images section. From the Image Generation Engine drop-down menu, select OpenAI DALL-E. Ensure the Image Generation Experimental option is switched on. Provide your OpenAI API key in the OpenAI API config field. Select your preferred model, DALL-E 3 or DALL-E 2. Keep in mind that DALL-E 3 has a minimum image size requirement of 1024 by 1024. Once satisfied with your settings, click the Save button and head over back to chat window. Use a text generation model to write a prompt for image generation. We asked the model to create a prompt to generate a flying boat image. After the response is complete, click the picture icon to generate an image. Here you have it. We have just generated an image of a flying boat using OpenAI DALL-E model. Keep in mind that generating images with DALL-E isn't free. You can find the pricing details on the OpenAI API pricing page. You can build or customize a model by modifying its model files directly using the OpenWebUI interface. A model file acts like a blueprint for your LLMs. It defines key aspects like model file location, system prompt, and the template. Let's create a model file by providing name, description, and the model file details to customize the model as a QA analyst. We'll call this analyst as Magic Tester. In the description field, enter the text. A QA analyst who can advise on how to effectively test software. Now enter the model file content details. We'll categorize this model as assistant. Click on the Save and Create button. Your model file has been successfully generated. By clicking the Share button, you can share this model file with the OpenWebUI community. You can also retrieve a model file developed by the community. Depending on the size of the model, you'll need to wait for the model file to download. Once pulled, this model file can be selected just like other model from the model selection dropdown. You can see how easy it is to customize our own model based on our specific requirements. Let's try out our magic tester. I asked the model to tell me about itself. The magic tester promptly responded to my prompt and introduced itself. Next, I asked it to generate test cases for testing the checkout flow of a POS app, and it produced quite an impressive response. OpenWebUI offers a variety of themes to customize the interface. Pick a theme that matches your style and makes chatting with AI even more enjoyable. You can streamline your daily tasks by creating frequently used prompts and saving them using OpenWebUI. Let's create a prompt to generate YouTube video script by providing the title and prompt content. Once done, click the Save and Create button. You can later access these quick prompts using the slash command. You can also import prompts from the OpenWebUI community. OpenWebUI also allows you to speak directly with your model. Click on the record voice icon and after granting microphone access, start speaking your prompt. I asked, create a Python program to develop a BMI calculator. The AI then transcribed my spoken prompt into the text input box. OpenWebUI enables you to switch between local models and OpenAI's powerful GPT models, providing a wider range of capabilities. To access OpenAI models, simply enter your OpenAI API key in the Settings under the Connections section. Once your key is added, these models will appear alongside local models, allowing you to interact with them in the same way. Now you've set up your own OpenWebUI server, but what if you want to use it from your phone, laptop, or share it with friends? The answer is NGROK. With this tool, you can enjoy the power of your self-hosted OpenWebUI from anywhere. NGROK establishes a secure tunnel between your local machine and their servers, providing a public URL that allows anyone with the appropriate address to access your locally hosted AI tool over the internet. To get started with NGROK, sign up for a free account. The process is quick and straightforward. Once you have an account, log in to your NGROK dashboard and download the NGROK client for your specific operating system. They provide clear instructions for Windows, Mac, and Linux. Copy the displayed command and run it by pasting it into your terminal window. After the execution is complete, copy the next command from the NGROK dashboard and run it by pasting it into your terminal window. This will add your auth token to the default NGROK.yaml file. Now it's time to deploy your OpenWebUI to the world. Copy the deployment command and run it from your terminal. Before creating the tunnel, make sure your local OpenWebUI server is up and running. Note the port it's using, usually port 3000. NGROK will create a secure tunnel and provide a public URL in your terminal. Now, you can share this URL with anyone you want to grant access to your remote AI playground. I accessed the AI server from my phone and could chat with my local private AI server without any issues. As you can see, OpenWebUI unlocks the power of AI on your machine, and it's perfect for exploratory tasks and informative chats. Plus, it's privacy-focused and beginner-friendly. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to like and subscribe for more content like this. And if you have any questions about OpenWebUI or LLMs in general, leave a comment down below. Remember, keep learning, keep growing.